Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Kaliga Pavana Hare Krishna Mahamantra Ki Srila Prabhupada Ki Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुवन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण We welcome all of you for this last session of Bharat Maharaja's pastime from the Srimad Bhagavatam. So this was the heading I had given. Dust of a pure devotee can cure the rust of false pride. Here you are seeing in the picture, yesterday you had heard about how the deer took birth as Jada Bharata. That's the third life, from Bharat Maharaj to deer and deer to Jada Bharata. And Jada Bharata had a very hefty body, but he behaved purposefully like a dull person. Although he was enlightened Paramahamsa within. So he went through two circumstances, I told you. One with his brothers who mistreated him. Another one was in the Kali temple where the dacoits tried to kill him. Now after he left the Kali temple, he proceeded in the forest, remembering the Lord, chanting his names, moving from one place to another, completely absorbed in devotion. So one of the days, following days, a king named Rahugana, he was a king of Savira. He was a pious king. He was going on a palanquin, as you see here, to go to one Kapilashrama, where he wanted to hear Bhagavatam. That was his goal. So naturally, he must be a religious king, pious king, spiritual-minded king. So while being carried on the palanquin and going ahead, some of the servants who were carrying him were finding it a little difficult to carry. So they were looking for a substitute in that place. And they happened to see Jada Bharata on the way. So they just called him and engaged him. So in the front you are seeing Jada Bharata here, lifting the palanquin. Although Jada Bharata is never used to lifting palanquin ever before. He was actually a Brahmana man. And he was a Paramahamsa, absorbed in devotion to Lord. He was not an employed servant in any company, nor under anybody. But he was suddenly pulled into this job of carrying him. So while carrying the king, the other three fellows who were Shudras, they were just walking on the road, trampling over all the ants. Whereas Jada Bharata happened to be an enlightened soul. He didn't want to crush the ants below his feet. So he was very attentive and alert to them, not to harm them, because some of the ants were crossing the road. So he put his foot this way, that way, to avoid putting his foot over the ants. And that caused
jerking of the palanquin. So the king was getting irritated by this. So initially the king shouted, he said, "Why the palanquin is jerking?" So the other servants got frightened, because sometimes if a king is very angry, he can even behead somebody. So they all said, "Sir, we are carrying the palanquin properly, but the newly arrived man, he is moving zigzag. Therefore, it is jerking. We are sorry," they said. So then the king waited for a while. Again, the palanquin was jerking this way, that way. Now he got really wild. Now he started not shouting, he was sarcastic in his speech. He told Jadabharata that, "Oh, you are a very thin man." Although Jadabharata was a stout man. "You are carrying my palanquin for a long distance." But actually he had just now started carrying it. He said, "You must be very tired to carry this, because you are the only one who is carrying my palanquin. No, nobody else is there." Actually, there are 4 people carrying. So the king was sort of teasing Jadabharata. Sometimes when you tease somebody, it's more painful than when you tell the truth directly. So he actually wanted to sarcastically speak and harass Jadabharata. That was his intention. But Jadabharata, did not get even the least affected. Now the king saw again it is going in a zigzag way. Now the king became very angry. See, if you hurl anger on somebody, they don't take it. It comes back on you, and then you become angry again. So he became wild now. He said, "You fool. Do you think you are thin? You are fat." And then he said, "I can punish you like Yamaraj punishes the people who are sent to the Yamaloka. And I am the king. I am your master. You are my servant. I can punish you and bring you to your senses." Like that he spoke. So this is what he narrated just now. He asked him, "Are you dead? How do you disregard the master's order? I will punish you," and all that. So now Jadabharata, for the first time, he opened his mouth to reply. Now, why did Jadabharata reply? Till now, he didn't talk to dacoits. He didn't talk to his brothers. He behaved like a dull and dumb person. But now Jadabharata saw that he's a pious king. He's going to Kapilashrama now. He's going to hear Katha. And he's also ruling the whole kingdom, Savira. So it's not good for a king to have wrong conceptions about life. So he thought, Jadabharata, "Let me tell him something from my own experience. I have passed 3 lifetimes. This is the 3rd life. So let me give him some knowledge." He took compassion on him. So he wanted to give knowledge. So when he asked the sarcastic words, "Are you dead despite of life?" That Jadabharata replied, "I am not this body. Fatness and thinness don't apply to the soul," he said. "Everyone's body changes." So when he asked, "Don't you know that I am your master?" Then Jadabharata said, "Sir, you may be my master in this life. You are a king, I am a praja. But next life, I may be the king, you may be a praja. Our positions can reverse, quite possible." And such things do happen. Like here in Pune, there was an RDM office where one young boy from engineering joined. There were 200 people working there. He was a very mediocre fellow in the lowest ranks there. An engineer. But he wrote IAS examination and then he cracked it and he became a top officer, IAS officer. So in the same office, out of 200 people, they made him number one now. Recently I met him. He was only 32, 33 years old now. And the boss to whom he was reporting, now that boss is reporting to him now. How funny this world is, you can see. Correct, no? So that boss is feeling very ashamed now. I was actually his reporting authority. Now I am reporting to him now. Such things can happen in this world. That's what Jadabharata said. Positions can change. Like once Radha Gopinath was telling a story. One man went to his sister's home during the vacation time. So in the sister's home, he used to put a canvas and draw pictures. He was an artist. So he was drawing some picture. And then he saw the servant maid came to the home and she was washing the floor, cleaning the floor with a a wiping wiper. But she was a good looking servant maid. So he drew her also. He drew her along with the mopping cloth and everything, along with her earring, everything. He just put it up. And then gradually he developed attraction for her. He asked her what's her name and everything, and he fell in love with her. Then he told his sister, I have decided to marry her. And sister was shocked. She is working in my home as a servant maid for the last 6 years. Now if you marry, she becomes what for me? Sister-in-law. Oh, she said, if you are going to marry her, you get lost, you can never come to my home. You stay some 20 hours away from our city. She felt very uneasy, because in this way, the positions can change in this world. Somebody who may be a servant maid may tomorrow be a sister-in-law. Isn't it? And that's what Jadabharata said. So, you know, these positions are temporary and conventional. Somebody is called by a particular post and he's not having that post permanently. Like, for example, in the post of chief minister or MLA or MP, that is only a post where people stay for a while and move off. Then somebody else comes in the same place. Correct, no? Similarly, you are a king, okay, but you are not king forever. Lord Vasudeva, Lord Krishna is the only master who is master forever, he said. He is the master. There is no equal to him. There is no one greater than him. And he is a permanent master, everlasting master, eternal master. Other than him, everybody else is changing their position. Brahma also is a post. Some jiva become Brahma in this Brahmanda. Another jiva becomes Brahma in another Brahmanda. Indra is a post. When Indra, Varuna, Vayu, they're all posts actually. So it's a temporary post, he told them. And then king said, I will punish you for your disobedience, like Yamaraj punishes a candidate in the Yamaloka. So further he said, oh, my dear king, I'm a self-realized man acting like a madman. What will you gain by beating a dead horse? Like that he said. Because you are angry with me, you want to beat me up or something, but your beating will not make any changes in me, because I am aloof from the body. I don't consider myself to be my body. My body is actually like a shell inside which I, the soul, is residing. When he spoke like this, immediately the king realized. And he continued, Jarabhartha continued carrying the palanquin, thinking that I am suffering my own prarabdha karma. I am supposed to lift it at this time. I will lift it, no problem. And when the king heard it, immediately king became surprised. He asked, who? King got down from the palanquin and asked him, who are you? Whose son are you? Where are you from? Are you the supreme lord? You are speaking such amazing. So he told this verse. All of you repeat. Naham Vishanke Swara Raja Vajran. Na Trakshashula Na Yamasya Dandat. Nagnyar Kesoma Nila Vitta Pastrat. Shanke Brisham Brahma Kulavamanat. He said, oh, great soul, I thought of you to be an ordinary palanquin lifter. Now I am understanding you are a realized Mahatma, great soul. So I don't mind, I am not afraid of the Vajra of Indra. I am not afraid of Shiva's Trishul. I am not afraid of Varuna's noose. But I am very afraid of committing Vaishnava Aparad. You are a great Mahatma, but I engaged you in my service. So that became an Aparad. So I am clasping your feet, falling at your feet. Please forgive me. Like that. Why are you wandering like a dullard? You look like an ordinary person, but you are a great soul. And for me, you represent Lord Kapila, because I am going to Kapila Ashrama to hear the Katha. But you are also perfect representative of Lord Kapila. And I am attached to family life. And now I am seeing enlightenment from you. So in this way, he started asking questions. I'm very pleased. Now he asked further questions to Rahuguna. He said, see, when I told you, you gave an answer, I am not this body, I am not fat or thin and everything. So, and then Rahuguna said, if you take a pot of sweet rice and you put fire below, just as the pot gets heated, the sweet rice also gets heated. In the same manner, I have seen that if you beat somebody or slap somebody, his mind is also affected by that. Subtle body also gets affected. So will the soul in the body not get affected by that external insult or punishment? What do you think about it? He asked one question. Another question he asked. You are saying master servant positions are temporary. That is all right. But right now I am a king and you are a praja. So as a king, do I not have the duty to punish the disobedient praja for rectifying them, for making them become proper people? So I am only executing my duty. When I told you I will punish you, I am punishing for your good only. So it is not the duty of a king to do that. And then the third question he asked, you said that, yeah, madman, I am like a madman, it's like beating a dead horse. But according to Shastras, Raghuna said, if a king punishes evil praja and engages him in his occupational duty, then the sinful activities of that praja is diminished. So it is for the good of the praja that the king punishes the praja. Just like, for example, if somebody did murder, you cut off his head in this life, then he doesn't have to go to hell because the punishment is already given to him here itself. So I am punishing you to bring you to the right occupation duty, which is to carry the palanquin. You are also one of the Shudras. So therefore, I had told you to carry the palanquin properly. So I am bringing you to your senses. So I am doing good to you. Like that is. So, and Jadabharata very powerfully spoke following this. It's a very long katha. But I will just exactly tell you the answers that he gave for each of this. He said, my dear king, you don't know the difference between body, mind and soul. You don't understand. The soul is completely aloof from the mind and body. And the soul can become so liberated from the body. Anything that happens to the body, the soul will not be affected. We can bring the soul to that platform. Example, when Jadabharata was about to be cut, did he get disturbed? See, he's speaking with realization. But the king doesn't have realizations yet. So Jadabharata defeated that point. Secondly, he said, why did I say master-servant positions are conventional? But they can't... one more example he gave for the previous point. Let us tell the second point. He's saying, and it's a duty of the king to punish the disobedient, he said. But then he told the king, my dear king, you are afflicted by false ego. Therefore, you are claiming it to be your duty to punish me. Actually, ideally speaking, you are supposed to be like a Raja Rishi. And then anybody in the praja will come forward to carry your palanquin. But when you behave out of false ego, to catch a man who is going in the street, everybody is not your servant. They may be your praja, but you can't engage anybody and everybody. If you engage anybody, you have to pay them remuneration, correct? No? For example, somebody may carry a sadhu in a palanquin free of cost as a service. But out of voluntary service for the sadhu, they are carrying the palanquin, correct? No? But the king's palanquin, he didn't come voluntarily to carry. Who? Jadabharata. He was caught and engaged. Because you are an arrogant king who is thinking that all praja is your servant only. Actually, an ideal king who is a Raja Rishi, he will treat all praja very carefully. And Srila Prabhupada had to be carried on a palanquin to his Prabhupada quarters in Vrindavan. So there were two devotees on either side who carried him, the palanquin type of thing. When they took him to the top, Prabhupada told both of them, I am very sorry, I am not supposed to engage you in this service. But these days I cannot walk up on my own. And they said, Prabhupada, you gave us service. We are so happy. You know, we would like to carry you everywhere like this. They're very happy. So although Prabhupada deserved to be carried, he felt he is not qualified to be carried. That is the way the mood is supposed to be. But this King Rahuguna arrogantly assumed that I can catch anybody and engage. Everybody is my servant. So therefore he said, a king can only punish the disobedient and bring them to the proper path, provided he is a representative of God. So you are afflicted by false ego. One another example you can give in this case, like Keshav Prabhu, who was the LA temple president in those days, in the 1970s. You know, he took a couple of devotees to go for book distribution in his car. So they went to a place and they had a standard policy that you should only distribute books to men. If any women want books, you can give books. But you should not talk more than 3-4 minutes. That was the standard. So he saw one of the two brahmacharis was talking to a girl for more than 15-20 minutes. She came with a group of girls and all the other group of girls went away and she was standing and talking to this devotee. So then Keshapu told the other devotee, hey, go and call him. So this devotee went to call him and this devotee said, Prabhu, I am preaching to her, I'll come. Then he told the president, he told him, go and call him, tell him enough of preaching, now he should come back. So that devotee came back reluctantly and then that lady went away. Then Keshapu called the devotee. The devotee said, Prabhu, you know, I am actually preaching to that conditioned soul. It's a suffering conditioned soul. And she said, my answers are very intelligent answers. She asked me questions and I answered them and she was amazed by my answers. She was thrilled by my answers. And she asked more questions. I was giving more answers. In this way, I was delivering knowledge to her and actually delivering her from Maya. So why did you call me? And Prabhu said, Prabhu, you are very delighted with her, not because she is a conditioned soul and you are delivering knowledge, but there is some amount of fascination between man and woman. So we have kept a policy so that you don't indulge too much with opposite sex. It's not proper for you. Your intelligence will get cheated by emotional experience. So because you are emotionally affected by her association, you think you are very intelligent, you are imagining. So it's not, but Prabhu, I was actually saving a conditioned soul, he said. For saving conditioned soul, there are so many other Mataji devotees, they are also distributing books, let them give. You are not the only deliverer for her. So he said, now you understand this example? Now, this boy was imagining he is delivering her, but actually his attraction to speak to her is because of her sweet behavior and then he is emotionally getting affected. How many of you understand this example? Yeah. In the same manner, he told the king, your desire is not to correct me and punish me for the sake of correcting me. Your desire is to punish me and show your kingship and lordship over me. Therefore, as long as that ahankara is there in you, you have no right to punish your praja. You can only punish if you can actually help. That means even being a senior or a superior devotee, when we want to correct a junior one, we should do it in a mood of service. So he told the king, you are not in a mood of service. Everybody is a servant except Lord Krishna. In fact, Krishna himself becomes servant of his devotees. He becomes a parsarathi. Krishna is in such service attitude in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, driving the chariot of Arjuna. Actually, Krishna deserves to correct all of us because he is already in the mood of what? Mood of master? No, he is master. But he is in what mood? He is in servant mood. Therefore, he deserves to correct all of us because he's always in a servant of the servant mode, Krishna. Like, you know, Arjuna is Yudhishthira servant and Krishna became servant of Arjuna. So he's acting in the mood of servant of servant. So he can correct everybody. So he told the king, you are not in the mood of servant of the servant. Yeah. And then he said, you are trying to punish me is like beating a dead horse, he said. And then the king told, your sinful activities will be diminished if I engage you in your occupational duty. He said, yes, it's a duty of the king to engage all the praja in their occupational duties. It is true. That I agree with you. But he said, for that you need to have the knowledge. He said, here are four bodies with legs and hands and their trunk, which are all made up of Panchamahabhut. And that is carrying a palanquin, which is also made of Panchamahabhut. And inside the palanquin is sitting one body, which is also made of Panchamahabhut. And inside that body is sitting one spark, spiritual spark, which is thinking himself to be the master of the other four sparks, which are carrying him. So he told that because you are not able to see the difference between body and soul, you are identifying with your body as a king, then you cannot engage your praja properly. And also, there is one very, very powerful verse. Sa vasthanatma vishyo parakto. There is one verse in the chapter. He says that, sixth verse in this chapter. You know what he says? That, my dear king, you cannot understand the nature of working of the mind. No? He said, and then in that connection, he said, for example, the mind, how it tricks the living entities. He gave an example. So if you are carrying a king on your shoulder, for example, it may appear like a very heavy burden for you. It can be for your mind. But imagine if there is a beautiful girl who says, can you please carry this suitcase for me upstairs? I'm not able to, there is no sliding this thing. I am unable to lift it, can you help me? So if a boy is lifting her suitcase and climbing up the steps and giving it to her there, so he won't feel the luggage very heavy. Can you say why? Yeah, there is a fascination, there's attraction. In fact, he will want to show her the heroism. See how I can carry. She will tell her, madam, you have one more suitcase? I can carry both also if you want. Correct, no? On the other hand, if Radhesham Das tells him, I have to climb up, I am 50 plus, you know, please kindly can you help me? Suitcase, he will look up and down. You know. Am I your coolie? Correct, no? He will ask. But if a young, beautiful girl is telling him, can you please help me? He will say, why not? I'll carry the suitcase. If you want, I'll carry you also. Isn't it? This is how mind tricks, like the Jadabharata explained. See, this example is given by Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur. He says, yeah. So he said, my dear foolish king, he said, you are thinking that mind cannot change. This is the way the mind plays tricks. Like that he said. So therefore he made him understand this. It's a very long chapter, the answer which comes, which is, Jadabharata instructed Rahugana very, very powerfully. And then after speaking, he told him, Brahu gunai tattapasana yati na chejaya nirvapanat grihatva na chandasanai vajalagni suryair vina mahatpadara jovishekam. He said, my dear king, one cannot get enlightened in this world and one cannot give up one's false pride unless one gets the dust of the lotus feet of devotees. He told him, therefore I gave the heading, the dust of false pride, arrogance can be, the dust of, rust of false ego can be removed, the rust of false ego can be removed by dust of the lotus feet of devotees. Correct, no? So what is the meaning of that? Even Prahlad says this, Mahiyasam Padarajo Vishekam, he says to father, Hiranyakashipu, who is also very arrogant. So the meaning of this is, dust of the lotus feet of the devotees means, first of all, one should try to understand the power of devotees, the greatness of devotees, how much Lord Krishna values his devotees. One devotee is Muktanam Apisiddhanam Narayana Parayan. It says, Koti Shvapi Mahamune. Amongst Koti Koti, Jnanis and Yogis Bhakta is one. And Lord says, Mad Bhakta Pujya Abhyadika. He says, anyone who worships my devotee, he is very dear to me than one who worships me directly. He says, so one should understand the value of devotees, greatness of devotees. Devotees of the Lord are like honeybees who always drink the honey of Krishna Katha. And they are least interested in material subject matter. And devotees of the Lord, they actually are very compassionate personalities. You know, even though the non-devotees are atheistic and they may trouble the devotees, like Hiranyakashipu is troubling Prahlad, Durvasa Muni is troubling Ambarish, for no good reason at all. Still, the devotees are very tolerant and they go on with their preaching and practicing and preaching Krishna consciousness. Therefore, it is said the devotees have three primary qualities: upakarita, saheshnuta, and ishwar ki prati ananyata. They are always, upakarita means helpful nature for saving the suffering souls. Saheshnuta means great tolerance. And ishwar ki prati ananyata means they have always undivided devotional service towards Supreme Lord Krishna. So such devotees who are also walking on the surface of the globe, they are extremely rare, and one should identify the devotees of Supreme Lord. They are not interested in going to demigods for attaining some material benedictions. They are not even interested to become Indra or Brahma also. They don't even want to ask for moksha also. They don't want to get liberated from the suffering of the material world. So such devotees actually want to go on loving and serving the Lord birth after birth. So he also, Tasmad, he says, Susanga. So in one of the verses he says that, my dear king, you have been having some understanding in life, but meet the devotees of the Lord, associate with devotees, and get rid of your false pride. And you know, may your heart melt in devotion to Lord Hari. And in that perfect state, you know, all enlightenment will happen to you. And then he said, as far as I am concerned, I have been King Bharata before in the first lifetime. And when Rahuguna heard it, he was shocked because Bharata was ruling the whole world. And he's a small king under Bharata, Rahuguna. Then he understood, my Lord, and I am sitting on the palanquin and Bharata is lifting me. Isn't it? So, and then the king, and then he told, but because I became careless and became affectionate to a deer, I became a deer in one life. And then he said, what all I did as a deer, and now I got the body of Jadabharata. And I generally don't meet people, I don't talk to people. But when I saw you, I felt sympathy for you because you are a leader and so many people are putting their faith in you and you are supposed to have a clean mind focused on Lord Vasudeva. And therefore I spoke to you. Now keep these things in mind and proceed in your spiritual life. And then Jadabharata immediately left and walked ahead. He didn't stay for a moment more. He didn't say, make me a Rajpurohit in your palace. He didn't want to become a priest, official priest in his palace. He had zero expectations from the king. Here is an example of Jadabharata preaching simply out of good wishes, selflessly giving knowledge to Rahuguna. So we also can see Srila Prabhupada was such a saintly person who simply wanted to save the world, save the people through his lectures and through his books and establishing the society, a large scale welfare Srila Prabhupada did. So we have some understanding of spiritual life, but still there are lingering anarthas in our heart, which again and again impel us to behave in irregular ways. So we have to get rid of them. And today I'm going to devote more time for the for the questions. I have more questions. Which one? This one? This is yesterday's questions, no? Before I go to yesterday's questions, I will answer. That is the one more question I had. Okay, I'll find out. Some more questions are pending. I will answer them. Correct now? Yeah, I'll answer this first. The 24th. Spiritual compassion versus misplaced compassion. Prashant Prabhu is asking, why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is called Gauranga? See, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, who is called Shyam Sundar. But when Shyam Sundar, 500 years ago, according to the Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna Varnam Trisha Krishnam, there's a verse, Sangopangastra Parshadam. It says that there are many places it says, Krishna in Kali Yuga comes as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but with what color? Golden color. So Gaur Anga means one who has a limbs of the body like golden. So his body is, because Krishna covered by Radharani, his external form. So that is Shyam Sundar covered by golden complexion of Radharani. So that is Gaur Anga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The difference is Krishna plays on the flute, but Gauranga Mahaprabhu does not present himself as Krishna. Rather, he carries danda, he becomes a sannyasi. There is one, just 1 minute. I had one song of and I could not locate it now. There is a Mirabai's one song where she talks about how Lord Krishna had curly locks of hair And when he comes to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has shaved his head. Krishna plays on the flute, whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu carries a danda. The Krishna wears pitambar, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is wearing sannyas dress. And Krishna is Shyam Sundar, and here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Gaur Sundar. Like that she writes. It's a beautiful song. Manit Prabhu is asking, how to avoid positive distractions during chanting? That is because you have some worry about your service on that particular day or something. So solve all these service-related problems in advance. And also while chanting, you have to take a resolve that I am going to get into chanting now, and after chanting, I will make all the plans. But the mind is not listening, chant loudly. Hare Krishna! When you chant loudly, then the mind will listen. People say, Manav Seva, Madhav Seva, what to tell them? I'll give you an article, remember, Social Service versus Krishna Consciousness. You can upload it in our, we will upload it in our site. You can take it from there. It's about 8-10 pages. It'll give you 10 points for you, okay? Regarding Madhav Seva, Manav Seva, yeah. Many times I plan to utilize early morning time reading Prabhupada's book, but I could not continue long. How to be determined, Prabhuji? That's because Guru Raj Prabhu, you must be going a bit late at night. One day it becomes 10:30 for you, another day you sleep at 9, it won't work that way. In a week, say one day or 2 days, you get a little late, it's all right. But on an average, every day you should try to sleep at 9:30. Then you can get up at 3:30, you can get up. 6 hours rest. Otherwise, you know, if you don't keep that sattva-guna and steady sleeping in time, we won't be able to do. So one more thing I will put it up is early to bed and early to rise. We have a video, no? So we will put up that video as well as get the advantage of rising in Brahma Muhurta. Both articles, we'll put it for all of you. All of you can go through it. Very nice. Okay, Nigam Prabhu is asking, Chanakya saved our country by the attack of King Alexander, Sikandar. Did he get distracted from his spiritual activity because he's doing mental activity for saving nation? No. Chanakya actually is a Brahmana, and Brahmana can give advice to the king. Like, for example, Samartha Ramdas is giving advice to Shivaji Maharaj. Like that. Buddha is giving advice to Ashoka. So it's always important that the kings take advice from Brahmanas. And in Brahmanas also, there are varieties of Brahmanas. There is Vipra, there is Brahmana, and there are Vaishnavas. Like it is said that Janmana Jayate Shudra, Samskarat Bhavet Dvija, Veda Patat Bhavet Vipra, Brahma Janati Iti Brahmana. And in Brahmana also varieties. Even if you see Dronacharya, he's a martial arts teacher, Brahmana. He had that skill. Now there are other Brahmanas who actually teach the Vedic mantras. There are certain Brahmanas who do Purohit. They go to the home and do Hit by doing some puja pat at homes like that. And there are Brahmanas who are learned in the Vedas. Some Brahmanas are learned in Vedanta also. Some are Kathakars also. They can speak Katha also, Brahmanas. Basically, Brahmana is an advisor. He can give advice. He can give teachings. He can study the scriptures and teach them. And he worships the deities. He worships the cows. He worships the Supreme Lord. Some Brahmanas are worshippers of Devatas also, or impersonal Brahman also. So there are many types of people. So Chanakya was such a Brahmana. He was very expert in giving political advice based on Artha Shastra, which he made from the Vedas only. Harsha Sai Pala Prabhu is asking, what is the way by which we can always be grateful to the superiors who are compassionate? You have to think about it. Make a list of things, what you received from them, what they have done for Prabhupada mission, what you have received from them. Think about it. You will be grateful. Aman Kumar Prabhu is asking, I'm not able to see good quality in devotees. How to improve, Prabhuji? So you can connect with some devotees who always appreciate the good qualities of other devotees. Ask them, I can't see good in this ex fellow. So can you please tell me some good qualities? And they will tell you. You can make notes. And then you can observe. Yeah, that's true. So that's what I would do. Pritish Patrapu is asking, if someone has met with an accident on the road, should a devotee help him? Or let Krishna save him? Or should we consider it to be a result of his karma and ignore and move on? No. Definitely we should help. Even a karmi, non-devotees, you will see, if somebody slips off from a scooter and falls, immediately they go and lift the person and stretch his hands and legs and they put the scooter properly. And definitely they try to help. So as devotees, we are supposed to be even more compassionate. One time, devotees are going on a Rath Yatra in Australia. Suddenly there was a fire that broke out in a building, in a fourth story building, third story or fourth story. When the devotees saw that, and those people were screaming, because inside the office there's a big fire ablaze and smoke is coming, but people have to jump out. They will fall on the ground like tomatoes. If a tomato falls on the ground, it'll just explode. No, they'll break their hands, legs and die, or they'll break their heads also. What to do? So an intelligent devotee pulled out the canopy of the Jagannath cart, and then four devotees were holding it like this and told the people, jump now. And they all jumped. Boom, 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 boom. Everybody in that office jumped. Next day there was a big heading in the newspaper that Hare Krishna devotee saved all the lives. Not a single person died. It came and Prabhupada appreciated devotee's presence of mind. Which goes to show that as soon as there is an opportunity for helping others, devotees would very naturally spring into action. It's not that devotees are callous or insensitive. No, we are not the body, we are the soul. Let them die and then they'll get one more body in the next life. They won't think like that. Subir Kachrupa is asking, like you said, 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. only for the spiritual activities for grihasthas. Is that enough? Kindly explain how a grihastha should best utilize his 24 hours. Please suggest the best schedule. Actually, I was telling minimum morning time. This is the minimum one can do, because you need 2 hours to chant at least, no? And after that, if you can, you know, worship the deities, if you go to Mangalarti, Narsingarti, Tulsi Arati every day, that'd be nice. And then in the office also, when you go to the office, you can preach to your colleagues. The lunch time, some people are having a Bhagavad Gita, Zoom talk. They hear in America, one devotee is doing for 350, 400 boys. They're having a Zoom lecture between 1 to 1:30. Half an hour they hear. Or sometimes they sit with their friends and introduce them to Krishna consciousness. You can carry Prabhupada books and distribute to them. If you're working in a company which is a cool job, say you go at 9 and come back at 6. Then you have more time in the evening if you can. Husband, wife, children, all can engage in Krishna consciousness. But I'm not telling like that, because many families actually are able to badly manage their duties. Especially when the children are small. But there is no limit to Krishna consciousness. You can expand your field of activities more and more. Andy Prasad is asking, I'm not able to chant even 2 rounds. I'm working in industry in shift. How to fix in Krishna consciousness? Okay. If you're working in 3 shifts, as soon as you come back, naturally you'll be very tired. You make sure you sleep 6 to 7 hours well. And after that sleep is over, when you get up, then you are fresh. Then you can chant 4 rounds. 4 rounds or 8 rounds also. If you can't sit and chant, you're feeling very tired, then walk and chant. No problem. If even walking, you're still feeling very tired, then you can jog and chant. In America, some devotees have a jet also. While jogging and chanting, still you are feeling asleep. You can put a jet of water in the ice. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Yeah. Then Krishna will feel pity for you, and then he will give you a lot of taste in chanting. Satyam Dubepur is asking, if someone is good in kirtan and chanting is 16 rounds alternatively, so is it good or not, Prabhuji? Even if he's good in doing kirtan, he has to complete his 16 rounds, compulsory. Japa is different, and kirtan with harmonium and mic, that is different. That there are young teenage youths also ready to do for 4 hours also, that type of kirtan. It has multiple reasons. So many devotees know about it. But chanting japa, it is your connection with Krishna. You can't impress anybody while you're chanting much. Therefore, your mind doesn't like it. But 16 rounds Prabhupada has prescribed to us, we have to chant. Avinash Prabhu is asking, can you please give some powerful tips for one who is very much lusty? Okay. First thing we have to do is keep away from the tempting environments. Most important thing. Second thing is, see, there are external allurements and internal allurements. First, get rid of the external ones. Then afterwards, still the internal, whatever is stored in the past will keep coming in the mind. So in order to erase that, we have to chant intensely, prayerfully. We have to beg Krishna to help us to overcome this. And we should not wet our consciousness again. Just like firewood, if you sprinkle water, it will be producing smoke while burning. Therefore, don't add more to that, more water to the firewood, it's not good. So that means keeping dry means detachment we have to cultivate. How do you cultivate detachment? If somebody is feeling very lusty, don't eat too much sweets. Just eat once in a week, only one sweet. Reduce the sweets. And also don't sleep in the daytime. And if you sleep in the daytime, your body gets heated up. So avoid bad friends, you know, those who talk dirty things. Avoid those friends. And associate with people, like for example, night while going to bed, you can chant Narasimha Stotram. There is one verse I'll show you from the fifth canto. So you can, when you're going to bed, you can recite this verse. We'll chant this. Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya. Namastejastejase Avir Avir Bhava Vajranaka Vajranaka Vajra Damstra Karma Shayan Randhaya Randhaya Tamo Grasa Grasa Om Swaha Abhayam Abhayam Atmani Bhuyishta Om Kshraum. You want to know the meaning of this? This is 5.18.8. Okay? What he says here? Please read the translation.
I offer my respectful obeisances unto Lord Narasimha, Narasimha Dev, the source of all power. O my Lord, who possess nails and teeth just like thunderbolts, kindly vanquish our demon-like desires for fruitive activity in this material world. Please appear in our hearts and drive away our ignorance so that by your mercy, we may become fearless in the struggle for existence in this material world.
Yeah. So Lord Narasimha will help you. You can chant this. And also while going to bed, you can put some nice kirtana Prabhupada or your spiritual master. When you hear it, you know, it immediately reminds you of the person who is singing. So your mind remains pure. So you don't get agitating thoughts. As soon as you get up in the morning, many people hear Kausalya, Supraja, Vishnu Sahasranam. Or you can hear there are Bhagavatam verses, recordings are available nowadays. Actually, we have to help ourselves to purify our mind and consciousness. Very important. Also, you can memorize some Vaishnava songs and keep singing like this song. Gopinatmamani Vedana Shuno. Gopinatmamani Vedana Shuno. Vishaye Durjana Sadakamerata Kichunahi Moraguna. Vishaye Durjana Sadakamerata Kichanayi Moraguna Gopina. So it's a very beautiful song. You sing such songs in a very prayerful mood, begging to Lord for help. Then you will see, you will get a lot of help. If you send a mail to me, I will send you a couple of articles also, which you can go through, okay? And Sharma Prabhu is asking, please advise, how could someone take out time, some time for reading every day if professional work life is not balanced? Then while going, coming and all, you can read also. Nowadays, there are audio books of Prabhupada available. You can play it in your car. And then like Amala Bhakta Prabhu is reading the book with very nice music background. You can just hear the book, Prabhupada's books. While traveling in your car, you can hear. So, or you can put your phone and hear it in the bus or train when you're going. Some take out some time. You may not get exclusive time to sit and read. I mean, I know life is very busy nowadays. While going here, there, we have to hear. Shailendra Janpur is asking, how to offer food to Krishna if you are outside of a home? Tulasi leaf is very important while offering food to Krishna. So you can carry some dry tulasi leaves. You can carry. When you know that you're going to travel outdoor, you can take tulasi and dry and keep it. You can add that. In case you don't have tulasi, still you can offer and request Krishna to kindly forgive you for not putting tulasi leaves. And you can chant Mahamantra and Krishna will still accept. It is better to offer to Krishna and then take rather than think Krishna Tulasi is not there, so you don't ask this, I will eat myself. You don't have to eat. We should first give to Krishna always. Then this is next day, correct? No? I'll continue. Yeah. Shyam Prayasi Devi Mat is asking, can we be able to identify which behavior or character are from our past life, good or bad, so we can nourish the good and be away from the bad? See, as I told you the other day, when malaria mosquito bites us and we get malaria, we don't know which mosquito bit us, which day it bit us, which time it bit us, where is the home of the mosquito. None of it you know. But you know for sure one thing, my malaria symptoms are seen now. So then you have to take the medicine. Similarly, we may not know about what impressions we brought from previous life and what impressions we're carrying from current life. But you know the difference between good and bad from the Shastra. Shastra says in 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, what is divine attributes? What are demonic attributes? You know the right from the wrong by attending the lectures and all, studying Bhagavad Gita. So from whether it came from last life or this life, sort out the good from the bad and remove the bad and stick to the good. Jayapal was asking, is it possible to compile question answer and release a book so that it can be helpful to refer anytime we want? The problem is this book is going to be too bulky. There may be thousands of pages to compile a book. Therefore, whenever you attend this type of sessions, you learn by hearing the lectures and also question answer time you learn. But you keep reading Prabhupada books, all questions will be answered there. Rupa Shri Lakshmi Priya Mataji is asking, if someone takes up devotion service due to some reasons, deviate from the process, act against devotees, is that also due to past life impressions? See, past life impression may be carried by us. Say we had some hatred for somebody in the previous life. One example I'll tell you. Daksha Prajapati had a hatred for Shiva. He committed offense in the first Manu, Swayambhuva Manu. Then five Manus period, long period, 71 millenniums each Manu. Then in Chakshusha Manus period, he was reborn. But because of offending Shiva, some hatred was there in the heart. That hatred didn't come on Shiva. This time it came on Narada. You can see that. So what I would suggest to you is we can sometimes sit alone and chant and then we can think, you know, how loving am I? How affectionate am I to Vaishnavas? How kind am I? How forgiving am I? Or do I show a lot of interest in being very critical, very judgmental, you know, and I want to criticize the devotee? So maybe we may be carrying some devotion from previous life and we are also carrying some bad qualities from previous life also. So therefore, in case some impressions are there now, we all can take a survey of our own heart. Because if we don't know about ourselves much, there are three types of feedback. Personal self-feedback, peer feedback, superior feedback. So self-feedback means you yourself observe by going at a point outside yourself and look at you. What type of person am I? Am I selfish or am I selfless? Am I arrogant and harsh or am I humble and submissive? Am I angry person? Or am I a friendly, mild-natured person? Or do I make snap decisions? Or I think and act in my life always? Am I, you know, too straightforward in my speech without bothering what will others feel about it? Or am I very sensitive and I very carefully speak what I want to say? Do I give feedback to people every now and then? Or I hardly give feedback, but I'm more in a mood of learning. So in this way, we can observe ourselves. You observe yourself. And also you can tell your friend to observe you and give you some inputs. Then you can ask your counselor or you know, authority and preacher and ask, what do you feel about? Please tell me about me. Actually, we all get, how many of you feel here you got some inputs from others about your conduct behavior? Correct? Now we all get. That's advantage. So we can note down and then we can modify. Then that gives us a clue. Like one time I gave a feedback to one devotee. So he immediately told me, Prabhu, you are giving me, you are conducting an operation without anesthesia, he told me. That was the first time I thought, really? Imagine you break open somebody's belly without anesthesia, how painful he will feel. Then I understood, okay, I'll be very careful now. Then I always thought, if I'm going to correct somebody, first tell some good things before offering the corrections, you see. So we can always take feedback and follow. Okay, Shailendra Prabhu is asking, whenever Krishna chose Maya, he chose Yoga Maya, not Mahamaya. So what's the difference between these two Mayas? And see, Yoga Maya in the spiritual world makes all the devotees think that Krishna is not God, but Krishna is my friend. Krishna is my lover. Krishna is my son. So the pure devotees like Yashoda and Nanda don't think Krishna to be God. And they think of Krishna to be their child. Just like Prime Minister of India, we all see him as a Prime Minister. But his mother will see him as a son. If you go and tell the mother, hey, this is Prime Minister, she will say, Prime Minister for you, not for me. For her, he is a son. Like that, that is Yoga Maya. In Mahamaya, people don't accept Krishna as God because they're atheist. So Mahamaya is a bad Maya. Yoga Maya is a good Maya. So Yoga Maya is actually spiritual Maya. And Mahamaya is material Maya. But actually, the Maya Shakti is only one. In spiritual world, she acts as Yoga Maya. In material world, she acts as Mahamaya. Like that. Like electricity is one. You know, if you put in a fridge, it's not that it's cold electricity. And heat pump, you put it's hot electricity. Electricity is only one. But it acts differently in heat pump and fridge. Like that, she acts differently. In the material world, Maya Devi makes us forget Krishna due to atheism. In the spiritual world, Maya Devi makes us forget Krishna due to love for Krishna. Roshni Maji is asking, how can we make our mind to read Srila Prabhupada books and become happy? Actually, for that, you have to begin reading Prabhupada books. That is in your hands only. If you can't read alone, then call some of your friends, 3-4 of you sit together, devotees, and read. Gradually, mind will feel happy. Initially, the mind feels resistance. Oh, it is too philosophical. It's boring. I have read half a page. Now I'll read tomorrow, not now. Mind may feel like this. That's due to our impurity in the mind. Just like a doctor gives you, like one doctor was giving an injection to a patient in the hospital. So the patient told, doctor, why are you so cruel to me? See, the neighbor is drinking a very nice smelling cough syrup. Why don't you give him injection and give me the syrup I can drink? So the doctor said, hey, that syrup is not for you. That's for him, for you injection. So injection, doctor is giving us injection for our own good only. Similarly, Prabhupada book reading may be painful for us in the beginning, like a bitter tablet or like a injection, but we have to do it as a duty in the beginning. And the duty will become pleasurable duty eventually. Prashant Bhu is asking, it is said following spiritual path is like walking on a sharp edge of sword. So it is general that we may fall down, but how to again get up and keep walking on the spiritual path? For that, first thing we need is repentance. Alas, I have fallen from my position due to my carelessness or due to my passion and due to my indulgence in Maya. Now I am getting kicks now. So let me, I am suffering so badly now, let me not forget the suffering that Maya is giving me. And similarly, repenting that I have done the wrong thing. Now I want to acknowledge it. And let me have gratitude for all the people who have taught me so many things. So many devotees have followed me up and brought me to this stage, but I foolishly fell off. So one can have gratitude. And then one should also try to rectify the mistake and reinstate oneself. One should do that. Actually, this I will discuss in the Hindi Katha starting tomorrow, Ajamil Katha. In that repentance will come, you will hear. Nishtha Mataji Chavala Mataji is asking, some relationships are our weakness. Even if we try hard, we cannot overcome such attachments. Please guide. So if these weaknesses which you are talking about are making you stop your Krishna consciousness or become weak in your Krishna consciousness, then it is pretty serious. Like Karna was invited by Krishna to come to Pandava side. He couldn't come because of his attachment to Duryodhana. You will see that. Kumbhakarna could not leave Ravana and come to Rama's side because of his bodily attachment to the brother. Correct, no? So in this way, we may have certain attachments due to which we may not go to the Lord's side. We may get stuck up in another side. So therefore, we have to take care that we should purify our attachments by giving Krishna to others. And if others don't accept Krishna, we say Tata and then we go to Krishna. Guru Raj Prabhu is asking, my brother is a very fond follower of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Whenever we meet there will be always a fight. How to deal with this? Oh, good question. In my very early days, in my 7th standard, I first read Ramakrishna's books only. Then I went to various other organizations also. So if your brother has any specific question or why the fight happens and what point, if you write to me, I can reply you, surely. Or I can talk to your brother on phone sometime and he can be inspired to chant Hare Krishna. And it has happened to a few people from different NITs across the country. They asked me many questions because I know the whole philosophy, what is there in Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, because we have read those books before. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa also speaks quite a bit about bhakti also. Bhakti Yoga also he talks. At the same time, the conclusions are jnani conclusions in his books as well as Vivekananda's books also. Conclusions of jnana marga. So actually, karma yoga, jnana yoga, ashtanga yoga, they all culminate in bhakti yoga ultimately. So therefore, I was very inspired by ISKCON philosophy. If your brother is interested, you can put his questions and mail me. I'm most welcome. No? And Jyoti Mataji is asking, what should we do when you visit your relatives and they expect you to sit and talk prajalpa with them and ask to go for outing with them? Please guide. Okay. So you may meet your relatives occasionally. So actually, therefore, a devotee should not only be a devotee, but a devotee should be expert also. To know, like for example, when you are meeting the relatives, you may ask about their education, ask about their career, you ask about their children, family, how everybody is doing. You only ask them in advance. So then they will feel that you are caring for them. You are concerned about them. And then it's a part of life that if you have some connections to some relatives, even at home also, even if all your family members are not devotees, they will expect you that you should be concerned about them from about things like, you know, it's a birthday, they are celebrating, they will expect you to be concerned about it. Similarly, you say your brother or sister got a new job, they will expect you to congratulate them. Your mother or father's health is not good, they will expect you to take them to hospital. So whether it be your own blood relationships or even distant relationship, a devotee of the Lord should be intelligent to satisfy the people by good talk for some period of time. And then you keep a measured talk. You don't have to talk all day. Talk for some time and then you can go on, proceed with your Krishna consciousness. In case they are favorable, you can talk a little bit about Krishna consciousness also to them. And sometimes they expect you to go with them for outing. First thing you have to check, where are they calling you? Are they calling you for a movie? Are they calling you for something which will be detrimental to your Krishna consciousness? See, sometimes they want to go to Red Fort. They want to go to Taj Mahal. You know, they want to go to Disney World or SL World. If it is not that harmful for you, once in a blue moon you have to go, it's all right. But if it is a regular thing, they expect every month, they expect you to come with them and go to different mundane places. Then you can tell them, 1 month we will go with you, another month I'll take you to temple, ISKCON temple. You can bring them. Or you can arrange your birthday festival in ISKCON, Govindas, and bring them there. So you give them Krishna consciousness also. If they are demanding, you can also ask them to take it. Subrata Karmakar is asking, is it okay to first make family into devotees and then become attached to them? Okay, if they're all properly situated devotees, you see them as devotees and you are attached to devotees, no problem. But oftentimes, we forget their devotee nature and then we become attached to something else. Therefore, Kunti Maharani expressed the fear. But if all family members are devotees and they have a loving relationship, it's very natural actually. Mother, father, brother, sister, they all have a deep... in fact, I can say the love becomes a million times thicker after you become a devotee and family members become devotees than the mundane, superficial, skin-deep love. The skin-deep love is very superficial. It's called masked relationships. Whereas when they become devotees, you see them as soul, they see you as soul, and the loving relationship is very thick, actually. Devesh Kumar, Thakur Prabhu is asking, we say that Krishna, Allah, Christ, and all other names of the Lord are nothing but Krishna only. So if someone asks, why do we not spell Allah or Christ instead of Krishna? Because that name is also Krishna. Yeah, actually Christians sing Alleluia. They sing a particular song. Recently, our Hare Krishna devotees, in one of the churches, they did a very big program. In the beginning, the church members sang Alleluia, and the devotees sang with them also, Christ's name, maybe for 5-10 minutes. And after that, the Hare Krishna orchestra was there, which went on for an hour. Very, very powerful. And our devotees are not against these names of the Supreme Lord. At the same time, when you say Krishna, it means Krishna with six opulences in full. It's full understanding of the Lord. But when people call him as Christ or Allah, their understanding is very meager. Many of the Muslims, when they call him as Allah, their understanding is God is impersonal. So, but they don't know the full explanation. Like Bhagavan, when you say, that means he has six opulences in full. So the awareness and the understanding which comes, and Krishna is a very dear name of the Lord. Just like one small kid was sitting in my lecture. I asked him, what is your name? He said, my name is Dilkush, he said. Oh, Dilkush, beautiful name. Then his friend told me, sir, this is not his name in the school. In school, his name is Dinakar. But his mother calls him Dilkush at home. So that's a favorite name, pet name. Similarly, you know, Krishna's name is Vasudeva. That's the name in the scriptures you find. But all Vrindavan Vasis will call him Krishna. Yashoda may call him Krishna, 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 Aravindaksha. That's like a pet name. So, which name is more favorite for a child? Official name or the pet name? Therefore, we call Hare Krishna. When you say Christ, Allah, it's like Vasudeva. It's like that. So, but pet name you call Kana, Kanu, Balu, Kanaya, Balaya, Krishna. That's a very dear name. So, we call him like that. So, Roshni Mata is asking, I showed affection towards Krishna to my grandparents, and then also they told that there is a lot of time for us to go. So how to get them to Krishna consciousness in their last days? Actually, if they have not practiced in young age, suddenly in last, when they become 70, 80, it becomes difficult for them to take to Krishna consciousness seriously. It's like a green bamboo is more easy to bend, a dry bamboo is difficult. But even in their old age, like when my father was like bedridden, the doctor told few instructions to follow. So one of the things he said, you give him whatever he likes to eat, you give him. And then he said, let him take to spiritual life voluntarily. You don't have to force anything. If he's liking it, you give. So I asked my father, how do you like to spend your time? So he wanted to hear Vishnu Sahasranam. So my sisters played Vishnu Sahasranam every day. And one of my uncles, he brought a book with big, big letters of Vishnu Sahasranam. And when he showed my father was delighted. He said, oh, my eyes were a little problematic. When I see these big letters, it's so nice. Can I have the copy? He said. So he gave him the copy. So then he started seeing the book and hearing the recitation, which he lovingly did. I didn't force him that you should take the mala and chant Hare Krishna only. Something spiritual is ready to do. My mother, on the other hand, was chanting 16 rounds. She was chanting regularly. So elderly people, they will not like to be forced by younger kids like grandchildren, granddaughter or grandson. So we can allow them to, you know, progress at their own pace. And we have to check what they like. Like my mother also likes Krishna Ashtakam and that kind of thing. And all she will sing along with her group. So she was very fond of songs. So there are some Tamil songs. I would like to see my mother hearing some Tamil Krishna songs and developing devotion to Krishna through that. If she cannot understand our hardcore philosophy well. The whole idea is everybody has, especially aged people, we have to see their comfort level and accordingly give them. And Majati Jyoti Mataji is asking, not able to chant 16 rounds regularly, but going to temple and attending classes regularly. But how to make regular chanting interestingly? Going to class is good. In fact, attending classes will increase your respect and understanding of Krishna. But if you can't chant 16 rounds, then you chant 8 rounds or 12 rounds, whatever is convenient to you. But keep one fixed number of rounds and stick to it. You should never go down in the rounds. You decide how many you want to chant every day, 4 rounds, 8 rounds, 12 rounds, whatever. But chanting is very vital. In fact, chanting will increase your awareness of the lectures which you hear. Chanting proper is the most important activity. So, in order for you to do chanting and make it more interesting, you should read books like I know we have Nectar and Ocean of the Holy Name by His Holiness Satchinandan Maharaj, Japa book by Burijan Prabhu, and there is one book, Chanting Hare Krishna by Srila Prabhupada also. So many books have come out which are available. There is one book called Divine Name by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In many of these contemplates, you get these books. And I also speak Japa talks every day. Probably there may be some 700-800 Japa talks, I think, by now. You can get them in japatalks.radheshyamdas.com. Go and check. It's 2-3 minutes. Hear a Japa talk before chanting. Prepare your mind and then chant. And Rupashri Lakshmi Priyamata is asking, does committing aparadha to devotees over and over in one life become an impression in the future life? Yes, it becomes an impression. It's true. In fact, aparadha is so serious that it doesn't go away even after you come to nishtha, ruchi, asakti, even bhava. Still aparadha remnants remain. And only in prema stage also aparadha's effect is slightly seen. But when you have a parayisha anubhava or a personal darshan of the Lord, at that time the aparadhas are finished. So aparadha is the last thing to go. Other things like punya, papa and all are nullified very easily. But aparadha is the last one to go. So we have to be careful. And Harita Gauri Shetty, Mataji is asking, if a person believes in God totally but doesn't believe in performing any pious activities or don't go to the temple frequently and thinks when God has created us, he himself will take care. You see, this person may be having some bitter experience with temples, or he may think the pious activities are blindly done by people. And there are people who have faith in God, and they have to be scientifically and logically presented. So we have a course, a six-session course called Discover Yourself. Probably your friend can go through that. It is available in www.game.radheshyamdas.com. Go there. The first six topics. Discover Yourself, 1 to 6. GAME stands for Gita for All Made Easy. So, game.radheshyamdas. In case you don't remember it, just put www.radheshyamdas.com and inside that you will find it. But many students across the globe have found it very easy. After going through the course, they developed a very staunch faith in God and started wearing dhoti kurta, chanting, dancing, and they developed faith. It's a very foundational course. And Ramya Srinivas Maji is asking, if you are not feeling well, is it okay to lie down and chant with chanting beads? Okay, if you are having feverish, you are lying in the bed, you can chant, no problem. But we should not go to sleep. The condition is you have to be awake. In case you are very tired, you are feeling, okay, sleep first, and then when you are awake, then you chant. Lakshmi Narayan Papati Mata is asking, due to office work, we have night meetings, which is making to stay in Tamoguna, which is not able to making me get up in the morning. How to balance? Please suggest. Actually, in India, people start their work at 5 o'clock, IT companies, and it goes till midnight or so, because American timing is different from Indian timing. So that becomes very great challenge for those working in IT circles. So I heard that some people have gone high up in the IT line, they don't have to stay so long because they have to give some guidance and let the team members do the work, and they can relax by 9:30, 10 o'clock also. After you go beyond the age of 35 or 40. Also, if you are working in an IT company late nights, if your age has gone beyond 35, 40, just check how much money you have saved. If it is reasonably enough, then you can take off from such a job. Do some lighter job. Generally, people have worked in any line for 15 years. They gather some weight in that line, and then they know, like they take some consultancy and very cool type of engagement, you know, which will engage you during the day and will not tax you at night. Then you can rise early in the morning. Jyoti Mataji is asking, when we practice bhakti, will the past life impressions affect our children who are not into bhakti? Actually, your past life impressions will affect you, your behavior. And if your behavior towards children is proper, then there is no problem. The past life impressions affect us, and our behavior can affect others if it is a bad behavior. Shailesh Kulkarni, 2 to 3 bad things happened in my past life when I remember, then I lose confidence and can't able to chant properly, can't able to preach and can't able to bhakti. So don't get stuck in your past. As it is said, worry may bury you. If only it didn't happen, it'll be so nice, people think. But it has happened. Forget about the past and look at the road ahead. So you can't change the past. Then why worry? So therefore, we should see, what can I do ahead? So you know, everyone has experienced that certain things happened in the past which we feel that should not have happened. But now you can't change it. The arrow that is, the sped arrow, the spilt milk, the spoken words cannot be taken back. So we always have to think, what can be done further now? Look the road ahead. And then forget about the past. In case it is difficult to forget, then you chant Hare Krishna and pray to the Lord, give me strength to forget the bad past and look at the future. And also associate with cheerful people, confident people, encouraging people who bring out the best in you. So then you will also, hooking to them, you will also feel confident. Gururaj Prabhu is asking, we hear that Vaikuntha airplane comes towards the end. Wanted to know whether it came to take our dear Srila Prabhupada also. And we couldn't notice it. You see, Vaikuntha airplane is spiritual. So when it comes also, we generally don't see it. Maybe once in a while, Krishna does a magic by showing the Vaikuntha airplane, as he showed in the case of Tukaram. Tukaram, who boarded the plane and he went, others could see it. But otherwise, the soul boards the spiritual plane, Vaikuntha airplane, and the body is left behind, and the acharyas are kept in a sitting posture in their samadhi. Their bodies are not burned because they have already purified their body completely, gross and subtle bodies. So how do we know that Srila Prabhupada went back to Godhead? I can very confidently say he went back. Why? In the last days, when he was lying in the deathbed, as we say, you know, they were only giving drop by drop milk in his mouth. Like that one drop. And then Prabhupada was telling them, wait a minute, he still was giving purport. Everything is moving and acting under the direction of Krishna. That's one of the last things he spoke. And then he closed his eyes. So where is the person in this world, you know, who utilized his last ounce of energy, even in the deathbed, to give purports, and that too with such clarity? So from his conduct, from his behavior, from his purity, from the kind of miraculous expansion he has done, we can very confidently say he went back to Godhead. Nava Sai Prabhu is asking, according to M.M. Bhavaswaran Bhavan, Bharata is in Diya's body while leaving his body. He remembered Krishna, but he got next body. Can you know why this happened, Prabhuji? Yeah. Actually, in Deer's body only, he was perfect. He could have gone back. But Krishna wanted him to come again as Jada Bharata to preach to Rahugana. Because Rahugana was also a great king, ruler. The Jada Bharata's body gave him an opportunity to leave behind that enlightenment which we are all getting now. Sometimes the Lord requests the pure devotee, please take one more life and do some good and come back to me. Devi Prasad Patrapul is asking, if Krishna is telling it is quick formula, is it rajasic to apply it then also? You see, where is Krishna saying it's a quick formula? Like bhakti purpose is, you know, the process is simple, but the application is difficult, he says. Although the process is very simple, you know, chanting Hare Krishna, everybody knows, even a child can say Hare Krishna. But you sit and chant Hare Krishna, one, you know, 16 rounds, it can go really tough. So because our heart is not pure yet. Is there any quick formula you heard which Krishna says, tell me? He says, Tasyaham Sulabha Partha. You can very easily attain me, provided you surrender. The surrender takes a lot. Sushmit Rastogi Prabhu is asking, Bharat Maharaj was in bhava stage. How he was having sinful reactions? Actually, what was a sin? Sin means disobedience to God. That's a simple definition. So Bharat was actually obedient to Krishna. After some time, he ignored Krishna. And he started turning towards the deer. And that's what we call as sin. Sudhir Sharma is asking, I have a small question about character and behavior. Will it be transformed by devotional service and prayer for anybody? Oh, the character and behavior can be completely changed. Mrigari was so degraded, a gruesome killer and hunter of animals. He became such a saintly devotee that he refused to even kill an ant after that. Chanting Hare Krishna can do that, yes. Guru was asking, many times we hear that one who chants some rounds, also for him, human form, a devotee family is guaranteed. But why Bharat Maharaj got a deer body? That I explained to you, The dear body was only to give him a pinch to make him understand that don't be careless. If Lord gave him one more human body, he can again become careless. But Lord gave him dear body to make him wake up. And then I told you, in dear body, 8 things I told you, because of which you know that it's not ordinary dear. The purpose of spiritual life was accomplished in their body. Rajkumar Prabhu is asking, why Nalakumani Guru were not sent back to Godhead? They just resumed their material form, demigod. Same question Subrata Karmakar is also asking. I told you the reason that they both were sent to heavenly planets to preach the message of Krishna consciousness to other Gandharvas so that they don't commit the same mistake. And then they'll go back to Godhead. Lord Krishna tells them, at the end of your life, you'll come back to me. Kaushik Prabhu is asking, we have heard that at Nishtha stage, devotion service becomes steady and anarthas would not affect devotion service. How did Bharat Maharaj affected at Bhav? Very true. So at Bhav, nobody can be affected. Therefore, we should know, sometimes the Lord uses his pure devotees to do such a thing, to teach the world. Just like in Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna cannot be put into illusion. But Lord requested Arjuna, my dear friend, can you pretend to be in illusion? Arjuna asked, how long? Only in the beginning. He asked, what to do? You have to cry. Cry for what? You should cry that I will not fight the battle. They are all my relatives, friends. And then after that, what you will do? Arjuna asked, I will chastise you. Oh, really? Okay. You can chastise me, no problem. After all, we are friends only. Ashochanan, vashochastum, pragyavadanascha bhashasi, gatasuna, gatasuchya, na anushochanti panditaha. And then Krishna said, why am I chastising you? Because if I chastise the readers of Bhagavad Gita that you don't know the difference between body and soul, they will immediately close the book, throw it and run away. Therefore, we both will do the drama, okay? So like this, Lord does drama with his devotees. Just like your mother-in-law wants her daughter-in-law to serve prasad, but the daughter-in-law is a computer engineer. She only knows how to work in a computer. She doesn't know how to serve prasadam. So then daughter-in-law is taking, she takes little rice and puts in one corner. And she takes this much bendy sabji and puts in the middle. And the mother-in-law is watching, my Lord, now this is the first week she has come to home. If I shout now, then mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, leelas will start. So what to do? So she doesn't chastise her. She chastises whom? Her own daughter. Hey daughter, why are you so foolish? You have put so much sabji in the middle and little rice in the corner. Don't you know rice should be more, sabji should be less? And what do you think the daughter will say? Sorry, ma, she will say. I'll take care. And then the daughter-in-law is thinking, oh, thank God. The shout that I am supposed to get went to whom? Her daughter. So the daughter is like the devotee. And the mother-in-law is like Krishna, correct? No? So Krishna scolds whom? Devotees. So that the world can learn through them. So some pure devotees, Krishna makes them behave like that. And through the devotees, the Lord teaches the world. So Bharat Maharaj is not fallen. We are all fallen, we know, in our situation. But Lord takes Bharat Maharaj, who is in power stage, to use him as an instrument to teach the world. Saurabh Sinapur is asking, in case of Bharat Maharaj, he directly got the body of human being after deer. But generally, evolution process is different. Is it only because of Krishna's mercy or some law's nature? No, actually, from a human body, whatever desires you have, you go to those bodies and by default, you'll come back to human body. Although there are many, many species are there, you don't have to go through all the species. Like if a human being commits a mistake, he becomes a monkey or something, he becomes a cow, then he again comes back to human body. Sagar Bhagavad is asking, does repentance wash out Vaishnava Aparad? Yes. If you repent for your aparad and then you go and meet the devotee and say sorry, it can wash out Vaishnava Aparad, yes. Hemachandra Reddy Prabhu is asking, our Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement will there for 10,000 years. I heard that till that time, only Vaikuntha Dwaras will be open and after the Dwaras will be closed. Hey, who told you that? What happens after 10,000 years? How the Jivas get liberation? No, Vaikuntha Dwaras will not close. Even after 10,000 years also, few souls will be liberated and they will go back to Godhead. But majority souls will be degraded. So that's going to be a very terrible situation, which will be sorted out by Kalki. But a few Vaishnavas, even in the last part of Kali Yuga also, Vaishnavas will be there. So that if any of us still are hanging around, they will be there to take care of us. But the number will be very less. Shubham Sharkapur is asking, you said that by repeated repentance, in dear's body, Bharat Maharaj got purified of sinful desire. So my question is, what sinful act Bharat Maharaj performed? That I explained. The sin is he got deviated from spiritual life. He became forgetful of Krishna. And he is offering ahuti, which is actually yajna. Kundu, once you do it with great attention and care because of Lord Vishnu. Imagine your guru is coming. You make the guru sit there. He's waiting for prasadam and you're looking here and there. You just don't give him any prasada. Is it not sin? Similarly, you ignore the Lord. That was a sin. Lakshmikanta was asking, what about those who take initiation cannot maintain because of previous conditions? Will he become a chandala in next life? But Krishna says unsuccessful people get rich brahmana body. See, if you take initiation, you promise to guru and you are not following, then it becomes a terrible sin. So one has to meet guru and take help from guru. What should I do now? I am finding difficulty. Guru will give advice. But if one ignores it and becomes sinful, and actually Krishna says if you did little Krishna consciousness and you stopped it, in the next life you are born in a Shuchinam Srimatam Geheng. If you did lots and gave it up, then you are born in Acharya's family. But if you did some Krishna consciousness and got into sinful activities, then one can become chandala also. One can become a dog also. Like the other day we read, if somebody goes to dham, like Vrindavan, to chant more rounds of Hare Krishna, but then he falls prey to illicit sex or something, the next life he becomes a dog or a monkey or a pig in the dham because of committing the sin. But the bhakti will remain. Again, it will continue eventually. So we should not commit sinful activities. Radha Krishna Ayyappa, Prabhu is asking, I am unable to wake up early in morning, not focusing mind on Krishna. So we are going to put something in our sight on the early morning waking up. You go through that, okay? Triveni Ramath is asking, if the baby monkey reverses us to mother and he have reversed the slapping mentality, in the mother monkey, what will she do? Being a mother, I raised that type of question. You remember the example I gave? That mother monkey was slapping the child monkey because child monkey was about to be torn by the dog. If a child slaps a mother back. So, of course, so don't slap your child too hard. Give a small slap, they will also give you only small one back. Of course, some children are naughty, they may give back a slap to mother. One of the most important thing in raising children is we have to learn parenting. How to bring up the children, how to earn the respect from the children. In Pune temple, we have a Art of Parenting book, bulky book. You can go to www.voicepublications.com. V-O-I-C-E and publications, voicepublications.com. You look for the book and you order it, you will get it. Then your child will never beat you when you follow that book. Daitari Swain, Prabhu is asking, how to engage all senses simultaneously while chanting? No. While chanting, you utter the mantra and you hear it. Other senses, like for example, utter with the mouth, hear it. Eyes, you keep it closed. Don't get distracted. And mouth, only should utter. Don't eat gulab jamun while chanting. Do only one activity of chanting. Other senses are already engaged. The mind is engaged. Thinking, feeling, willing is engaged in Lord service when you are chanting. And your legs are sitting in a particular posture, Samadhi posture, Padmasana or something. That is the best posture to serve Krishna instead of moving around. It's better. So now we have answered up to this. Now that this is still yesterday's and today's are remaining questions, isn't it? So what to do? How many? Another 7 pages of questions are there like this. So I don't know when will I answer these questions. So tomorrow I am starting... tomorrow onwards, I'm starting a new series. In Hindi, I'm starting Ajamil Katha. And in English, Gita Rahasyam. So what is Gita Rahasyam? You will come to know the Rahasyam tomorrow onwards. You will see. So that will be one chapter a day. In 18 days, I'm completing 18 chapters of Bhagavad Gita. So I will take the most vital aspects of every chapter and speak it each day. So... you all got some questions. In case you feel that your questions are not answered, maybe as the course of speaking Bhagavad Gita, I can answer them. In case the question is relevant, you can send. There's an ocean of questions and we have time limitation. So tomorrow onwards, we're going with a new theme. In Ajamila Hindi, you will learn many things about the glories of the Holy Name and what is the aparadhanam? What is the namabhas, aparadhanam, namabhasan, shuddhanam? You will learn about what is sin and how does sin happen. sinful reaction and sinful propensity, how to eradicate them. So we also will learn about Vishnu Dutas, Yama Dutas, what happens at the time of death. So many things are taught. It's a very, very amazing, enlightening section of Bhagavatam, Ajamil Katha. I'll do that between 4:30 to 6. But one good news for all of you, 4 to 4:30 and 6 to 6:30, we are going to have a team of very sweet singers, extraordinary singers and instrument players. They will all be performing a kind of kirtan performance. So my request to all of you, 4 o'clock you can join, 4 to 4:30 hear the kirtan, and 4:30 to 6 I'll do the Hindi class. 6 to 6:30 again the kirtan will be there, and then 6:30 to 8 will be our class. So which means 4 to 8, how many hours? 4 hours you have complete engagement. One Hindi class and one English class. You can join as per your preference. We have uploaded in our live.radhishandas. We uploaded the pamphlet, right? Okay, we uploaded the pamphlet. You can see that. So thank you all for your enthusiastic participation all these days. And it was very nice discussing Krishna Katha. I thank you all for giving me an opportunity to glorify Krishna all these days. If you are not enthusiastic, then I'll be just sitting and reading in my room. But you are all very enthusiastic in connecting and spending your time, like we said, converting quarantine into divine. So you have heard, some of you had come for both Gajendra Moksha and Bharat Maharaj. Some of you had come for Bharat Maharaj section, and many, many things you learned. And all these PPTs and many of the further files I have uploaded in our site. You can go through it leisurely. And if it was of some help to you and you are happy about it, then I'm sure Krishna will bless me to make one forward step in my spiritual life. And many, many devotees wrote to me back saying that, please don't stop it, Prabhu. It was very nice. We want to continue. So therefore, I am starting Gita Rahasyam tomorrow. Actually, Gita has many vital points. If you capture those vital points, you understand. Even if you don't know all the details, still you will know Gita, the vital aspects of Gita, which is very essential for one to become a first-class devotee. So those are the points I'll be capturing and elaborating on in my talks. So you're all welcome again till our Prime Minister of India has announced till 14th, but I am keeping our classes till 15th. So if you all come with the same enthusiasm, it would be very nice. And you can also inform others. Many people nowadays want to learn Bhagavad Gita systematically. And the Bhagavad Gita, as it is, when they read verse by verse, sometimes they find it difficult to capture the Sanskrit and everything. But this can be a good introduction for them. You can inspire them to join. Can you do just short kirtan? Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare.
Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Hare Ram, Hare Ram,
everybody together.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram, Ram.
Once more.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram, Ram.
One last time.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
హరిపావన హరినామ సంకీర్తనకి
జయ
అనంత కోటి వైష్ణవ వృందకి
జయ
శ్రీల ప్రభుపాదకి
జయ
గ్రంథరాక్షిమద్భాగవతంకి
జయ
నితాయ గౌర ప్రేమానంది
హరి హరి బోల్.